Hello everyone, welcome to lecture 19. In this lecture, we'll continue talking about the electromagnetic properties of soils, mostly the complex permittivity. So if you recall the permittivity and relaxation behavior of water, you have electronic resonance and the ionic resonance behavior and orientational relaxation. And double layer, the relaxation, a special relaxation because of the double layer in clay, kaolinite or bentonite. So clay. And this is the water. So this is the water molecule is spinning, right? At the orientational relaxation, and the frequency range is around like 10 gigahertz at 10 gigahertz. And the kaolinite, the double layer, there's a clay particle and the water is here, and this becomes like this, and it's called the spatial relaxation or spatial like polarization. And the range is around like megahertz, eh? So 10 kilohertz to megahertz. So keeping in mind that at high frequency, volume fraction affects the kappa of the mixture. At low frequency, at volume fraction of the water affects the kappa of the mixture. And at low frequency, the composition of the solid and fluid phase and the spatial distribution of phases and their interaction affects. Yeah? So it's more complex. When you look at the value here, this is the kappa prime at radio frequency is at around like megahertz, and you can see it's like paper, Teflon, wax, glass is like 4 to 10, diamond, and quartz is around like 4. Here again, the quartz is 4 to 5, calcite is around 8, mica 6, dry soil, dry sand, okay, 2 to 4. So very small kappa prime, and water is at around 80, and methanol is around like 32. So if the soil contains the water, then saturated soil is around 50, and frozen water, if it's frozen, then it's about like 3. So it means that the ice has very low permittivity. Frozen water, yeah. So fluid, the polar molecule will be water, so it will rotate in the presence of electric field. And non-polar material like chlorine, benzene, carbon tetrachloride do not rotate. So when you look at the value, the kappa prime is really small. If it's water, with the increasing ionic concentration, what will happen to the kappa prime? You can see at low frequency, when the frequency is less than megahertz, hertz to kilohertz, as the concentration increases, so kappa prime is proportional to concentration, okay, with the power exponent of 0.5. And it can be explained by the Debye-Hückel's theory. And at high frequency, when the frequency is bigger than the megahertz, then the concentration and mobility affect the kappa prime, and the real permittivity, as you can see in this the graph, decreases with increasing concentration due to the reduced mobility of the molecule involved in hydrating ion. So it means that the kappa prime is number of water molecule polarization, right? So if you have more molecules to be polarized, polarizable, then you have high kappa prime. But when you have a sodium ion or chloride ion, then what happens? Water will be hydrated, hydrating the ions, right? Surrounding these cations. So then this water molecule will not be polarizable as much as the bulk water. So as the ion concentration increases, you can see kappa prime decreases quite dramatically. So at like 2 mole, it can decrease it to like 60 from like 80. When you look at the permittivity spectra, so this is the effect of frequency. So if frequency changes from 0.1 gigahertz to here is the 1 gigahertz. So it's a little bigger than gigahertz. And the deionized water doesn't change, but the sodium chloride solution decreases a little bit. So increasing kappa, but here immunity value change is much bigger. And DC conduction, sodium chloride solution, the kappa imaginary, the effective imaginary permittivity decreases with the increasing the frequency. And that's the contribution from the DC conduction. So as the frequency decreases, that you get the more like sigma DC, like here kappa effect is plus sigma omega epsilon naught. So as the frequency decreases, then the dispersion increases, so that you get the linear increasing with decreasing frequency. If the ionic concentration is very low, then this part is almost zero, right? So then you get the orientational polarization close to the 10 gigahertz. So if it's just water, pure water, then if you go back to the spectrum that we've seen here, then it will be, so as the frequency increases, the kappa prime will go up like this. So here it's at around 10 gigahertz. And this will be the region that you're looking at, and maybe far right, and you have a resonance peak because of the orientation of polarization of the water. So the increase in kappa double prime with increasing frequency corresponds to losses due to the orientation of polarization loss. The static real permittivity decreases with temperature increases due to increased random vibration and collision between water molecules. Both effects hinder polarization. At very high temperature, the average polarization factor increases because of the breakdown of the internal water structure and results in an increase in the dipole moment due to the reduction of the bonds. For the pressure, in the case of low density fluid like gas, an increase in pressure implies a higher number of polarizable units per volume, therefore the permittivity increase. But in the case of the high density fluid like a liquid water, permittivity decrease with increasing pressure because the pressure will collapse the hydrogen bonded local structure, a change in length of the OH bond, or a decrease in molecular size. When we mix with the organic fluid, so this is the case, the alcohol, glycerol, xylene, benzene, toluene, and some other like chlorobenzene. And glycerol, isopropyl alcohol, it shows the relaxation behavior, right? Like here. And significant polarity and small losses at low frequency indicate the limited DC conduction. So these are polar material. And these are nonpolar. And you can see the kappa prime is around like 2. And the kappa double prime is almost 0. And here is almost 0 double prime. Here, but the value is around like the real value is like 2 to 4, and effective imaging permittivity is almost zero, huh? Because it's non-polar material. So using this in the if the soil is contaminated with some oily liquid, then we can also use this kind of a permittivity monitoring or like survey to detect where they are contaminated. If it's dry soil, you can see that the imaginary value, the kappa double prime effective is almost zero. Dry kaolinite and dry shale. But real value is around, like if it's shale, it's like 8, and the dry kaolinite is 2 to 3. The dry soil have real permittivity value less than 10, and no relaxation was observed in the frequency of 20 megahertz to 1.3 gigahertz. So if it's dry soil, the complex permittivity will be really low. So that's why we can use the GPR or TDR, which measures the dielectric constant, to estimate the water content. Mostly these properties, the real value, they refer to the real value of the permittivity. Okay, let's look at the soil and water mixture. This is the spectral response, and here the first graph is the real and imaginary. The second one is, and it's a kaolinite water mixture. Permittivity is at the frequency less than 10 kilohertz. So somewhere here is mostly biased by the electrode polarization for the real value. But for the imaginary value, it measures, it captures well, even despite with this electrode effect. Decreasing permittivity suggests a wide relaxation due to spatial polarization extending across the kilohertz frequency region up to almost 100 megahertz. And so here in this region is mostly like double layer polarization. So spatial polarization, so you have, if you have a double layer, double diffuse layer, then the ion will be polarized in that the diffuse layer. And the effective imaginary permittivity is governed by the DC conduction at radio frequency. So if we compare the kaolinite water mixture and the monmolyonite water mixture, specific surface area of kaolinite is much smaller than the specific surface area of monmolyonite. This will be around like less than 100 square meter per gram, and this one will be around like 600, and the liquid limit is also really high, so it has very thick, the monmolyonite has thick double diffuse layer, and kaolinite is thin double diffuse layer. So then it makes the difference. The orientational relaxation of the bulk water, like pure water, how they orient, these are not, this orientation relaxation is not different in kaolinite or the monmolyonite mixture. But when we look at the like interfacial polarization, the double layer polarization, then it becomes different. So you can see because it's thicker, relaxation occurs much higher frequency, so around it 0.1 gigahertz. But in the case of, where is it? In the case of kaolinite, because it's thin, then it's around like 1 megahertz, less than 1 megahertz. So no difference of orientation relaxation between observed water layer and free water in Carolina due to the small specific surface and the thin double layer, but the orientation or relaxation between observed water layer and the bulk water is much different in bentonite or monzonite. So this is from observed water polarization. So let's compare here shows the more data on the kaolinite, the saturated kaolinite and the saturated bentonite. Bentonite is composed of mostly the monzonite. So real permittivity increases with increasing water content, and this is the same with the bentonite here, so also it increases. In the permittivity, conduction and orientation of polarization losses into play. So you can see at the very low water content, as the frequency increases, it decreases right here, but as the water content increases, now the frequency, with increasing frequency, the permittivity increases. But in the bentonite water mixture, at gigahertz here, so if you look at this, this will be somewhere here, right? So at gigahertz in this region. So effective permittivity decreases with increasing frequency. So more pronounced relaxation than the kaolinite, and the effective kappa double prime imaginary value shows the effects of DC conduction losses and the orientation relaxation of observed water in this frequency range. So the water content and the specific surface area. So here we are comparing the sand and silt and clay at different water content, right? So the x-axis shows the water content, and permittivity is governed by the water content rather than the gravimetric water content, the volumetric water content, and permittivity is proportional to the number of dipole moments per unit volume. So here in the sand, sand is non-conductive, and it has very thin double diffuse layer, almost no double diffuse layer, so that as the water content increases, the permittivity increases regardless of the frequency. So the TDR, water content measurement, measures the water content well if it's like sand. But as the, as the space surface area increases, now it becomes more deviated, and it shows more variance because of the different relaxation mechanism. The real permittivity of the sand is almost linear with the volume fraction of the water, does not affect it by the frequency. However, the real permittivity of silt and clay does not vary linearly with water content and is frequency dependent due to spatial relaxation of double layer and the surface conduction. So when you use TDR to get the water content, like volumetric water content, you have to be careful what's the composition of your soil, and if it's very highly high species of a soil, then you may have to carefully calibrate before you use it. And here shows the effect of electrolyte. As the gravimetric water content increases, here the real permittivity value does not show much difference whether you use deionized water or like sodium chloride or like potassium chloride or the calcium chloride or the iron chloride. So here this is the balance is 3 plus, 2 plus, and plus 1 and plus 1. But in the imaginary permittivity shows a lot difference. This is the FeCl3, and this is CaCl2, and KCL, NaCl, and DiOR. In region 1, here in this region shows a low rate of increasing real permittivity since the polarizability of the bound water is low. Since the availability of the fluid is limited, conductivity is controlled by discontinuous conduction, pass, and strategy affected by the cation balance. In region 2, here in this region, when the water content is enough, this is the bentonite, and gradual prevailing effect of the free fluid chemistry, the effect of ion valence, and the size on kappa double prime. The real permittivity at 200 MHz is minimally affected by the valence of the ion, but for DINF water, a decrease in effective permittivity at water content greater than WC indicates the reduced effect of surface conduction. The conductivity of the electrolyte increases as the valence increases. This shows the permittivity at different solution, the sodium chloride and the potassium chloride and the calcium chloride and the iron chloride. And here, this is the kaolinite, and decreasing real permittivity with increasing concentration reflects the reduced mobility of the water molecule involved in ion hydration. And the effective measuring permittivity captures the conduction and orientation of polarization losses. The increase in losses with increasing concentration is due to higher DC conduction losses. So as the concentration increases, this part increases faster than the frequency increase, so that the kappa double prime effective increases. So mostly the increasing the loss, this is the loss term, kappa double prime effective, is due to the conduction losses. So as the sigma increases, the kappa double prime effective increases. There are several empirical relations, the permittivity of the soil mixture versus the volume fraction of the water content, water. And as you know, the DW, so here the DW is 0 to 1. The range is 0 to 1. And there are several empirical relations. And this is based on the geometric mixing relation, like whether it's parallel model or series model or in between. And organic mixture, the real permittivity of the clay water mixture is higher than the clay organic mixtures because of the orientation polarization of the free water. Free water, the kappa prime is like 80, and the other materials will be much lower than that. The permittivity of the clay organic mixture is higher than that of the individual component, and the relaxation is observed in the bentonite specimen. So as the kappa prime of the bentonite is contribute to the mixture, when it's the clay organic mixture, the mixture value is higher than the pure fluid. Okay, you can read it through. And temperature effect. At high frequency, the change in soil permittivity with temperature is mainly due to change in free water permittivity. And at low frequencies, temperature affects the conductivity of the pore fluid and spatial polarization, double layer polarization, double layer formation, and mobility and bound water polarization. Contrary to free water, increasing real permittivity with increasing temperature can be seen for the bound water. Okay, these are the suggestive readings, and thank you for listening.